Good morning, class 10th. Today we will continue with the chapter 1 of civics, the Union Parliament. Today's topic is motion, which comes under parliamentary procedures. We will discuss the following points. So the objectives of today's topic is motion of thanks, substantive motion, motion for removal impeachment, adjournment motion, no confidence motion, call attention motion, privilege motion, censure motion, cut motion. Now let's discuss some keywords. Number 1, debate, it means discuss. Number 2, impeach, it means challenge. Number 3, immense, means huge. Number 4, termination, means end. Number 5, distorted, means respect. Motions. Whenever a matter of urgent public interest is sought to be discussed in the House, it is called a motion. Motions can be of various kinds. A motion refers to a formal proposal asking the House to take some action. Motions can bring new matter before the Assembly or consist of numerous other proposals to take procedural steps or carry out other actions relating to a pending proposals. Motions can be of different kinds. Number 1, motion of thanks. First session of every new parliament and first session of every fiscal year is addressed by the president. This address by the president is moved in the house, debated. Debated means discussed and approved. Such a motion is called motion of thanks. Motion of thanks is a motion in Indian Parliament which follows the address of the President of India to the joint sitting of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha at the beginning of the first session of a new Lok Sabha and first session of every year. Number 2, substantive motion. It is a resolution. Resolution means decision of the House giving express opinion of the House on a particular matter. Substantive motion is a self-contained independent proposal submitted for the approval of the House and drafted in such a way as to be capable of expressing a decision of the House. Third, motion for removal, impeachment. Impeachment means challenge. If the President, Vice President, the Speaker or judges of the Supreme Court and High Courts act in violation of the Constitution, the Parliament can move to remove, impeach, means challenge, such a dignitary. Dignitary means VIPs. If the President, Vice President, Speaker, judges of the Supreme Court or High Court breaks any law against the Constitution, then they can be impeached or removed by the Parliament. The President can be removed from office by 2/4 majority in Parliament. Cabinet ministers can be removed by Parliament if they violate any law against the Constitution. Adjournment motion. Daily business of the House is programmed well in advance and is conducted accordingly. But if a question of immense means huge, public importance crops up means happen, the members can demand adjournment of the discussion on slated means awaited business and discuss that matter immediately. Adjournment motion is the procedure for adjournment of the activities of the House for the purpose of discussing a definite matter of urgent public importance, which can be moved with the consent of the Speaker. Daily meetings of the House is well conducted in advance. But if a matter of public interest comes in Parliament, then the members can demand for the adjournment of the discussion on the previous matter and discuss that important matter immediately. Besides that, the House has to be adjourned after the business for the day is over, when the death occurs of a sitting member of the House, when there is so much disorder in the House that is, it is difficult to conduct the business for want of the quorum, or as and when the Speaker finds it necessary. An adjournment is a break in the course of parliamentary business. The house adjourns at the end of each day's activity. Death of the sitting member of the house occurs. The chairman may also adjourn a meeting in the event of disorder or other like causes when it becomes impossible to conduct the meeting and complete its business. Or if the speaker feels that the behavior of the members of parliament are disruptive, then he or she can adjourn the house. There is a difference between adjournment and prorogation. An adjournment suspends the sitting of the house. Prorogation means termination. Termination means end of session of parliament. Prorogation ends the session. Power to adjourn the house belongs to the speaker, but prorogation is done by the president. Prorogation means the action of discontinuing a session of parliament without dissolving it. There is difference between adjournment and prorogation. In adjournment, only sitting is terminated, not the session of the house. But in prorogation, sitting and session both terminates. Power to adjourn the house belongs to speaker, but prorogation is done by the president. In adjournment, it does not affect the bills, but in prorogation, it also does not affect the bill, but all pending notices lapse on prorogation. No confidence motion. In a parliamentary setup, the Council of Ministers work till it enjoys the confidence of the legislature. If a successful motion of no confidence is passed in the Lok Sabha, the Council of Ministers has to resign, and if on the other hand the majority votes against the motion, the government survives. No confidence motions are very important because when a debate is held on the no confidence motion, members discuss the general policies of the government in detail and not the matter of a particular bill. In such a way, much light is shed on different problems and the attitude of different parties towards them. A motion of no confidence is a vote which states that person in a superior position, be it government managerial, is no longer fit to hold that position. In parliament, the Council of Ministers works till it enjoys the confidence of the legislature. If an individual minister loses the confidence vote, he or she must resign. If the Prime Minister loses the no confidence vote, his or her entire government has to resign. It is a trustworthy instrument to make government accountable. Call attention motion. A member of parliament may, with prior permission of the speaker, call the attention of minister to any matter of urgent public importance, and the minister may make a brief statement or ask for time to make a statement at a later hour or date. This is called call attention motion. This motion aims to bring attention of a concerned minister to a matter of urgent public importance with the prior permission of speaker. The minister then responds on the matter. The calling attention motion is a unique Indian innovation in modern parliamentary procedure. Next, privilege motion. A privilege motion is moved by a member if he feels that a minister has committed a breach of privilege of the house or any one or more of its member by withholding. Withholding means hold back the facts of a case, or by giving a distorted means misrespect version of facts, etc. Members of parliament enjoy certain parliamentary privileges which grant to them collectively and individually so that they can discharge their duties and functions effectively. In case that any of these immunities or rights are disregarded by any MP, the act is regarded as a breach of privilege and is a punishable offence under laws of parliament. Censure motion. This motion is brought to disapprove, means dissatisfaction of or criticize certain decision or policy of the government. The member should state the reason why he or she is moving the sensual motion. It is a different from no confidence motion. A motion of no confidence need no specify the grounds, whereas a sensual motion should specify the policies or acts that are being censured. The government is not obliged to resign after the passing of a sensual motion. But if a motion of no confidence is passed, the government has to resign. A censure is an expression of strong disapproval or harsh criticism. In parliamentary procedure, it is a debatable main motion that could be adopted by a majority vote. It is different from no confidence motion. No confidence motion may lead to dismissal of the Council of Minister or other position holders, whereas censure is meant to show disapproval and does not result in the resignation of ministers. Cut motion. When the budget is being discussed or debated upon a motion for the reduction means cut of a demand of grant may be moved. There are three types of cut motions. Cut motions are motions in the parliament moved to reduce the amount of demand. The demands usually made in respect of the grant proposed for each ministry. But parliament, being the authority to check the expenditure of the government, it may not approve all demands. Token cut. To air a particular grievance, the motion says that the amount of demand be reduced by ₹100. A token cut motion is moved so that the amount of the demand be reduced by ₹100. This is to express a specific grievance. Grievance means injustice, which is within the sphere of the responsibility of the Government of India. The discussion thereon shall be confined to a particular grievance specified in the motion. Disapproval of policy cut. To upset, to embarrass. Embarrass means upset a government. A motion may be moved that the amount of the demand be reduced to ₹1. Disapproval of policy cut motion is moved so that the amount of the demand be reduced to ₹1. It represents the disapproval of the policy underlying the demand. A member giving notice of such a motion shall indicate a precise term, the particulars of the policy which he proposed to discuss. The discussion shall be limited to the specific points which are mentioned in the notice, and it shall be open to members to advocate an alternative policy. Economy cut. When the aim is to affect economy, the motion says that the amount of demand be reduced to a specific amount. An economy cut motion is moved so the amount of the demand be reduced by a specific amount. It represents the economy that can be affected. Such specified amount may be either a lump sum, reduction in demand, or omission or reduction of an item in the demand. The notice shall indicate briefly and precisely the particular matter on which discussion is sought to be raised, and speeches shall be confined to the discussion as to how the economy can be affected. Now the fact file. The 12th Lok Sabha had the shortest tenure, just 13 months in the parliamentary history of India. It was dissolved by the president and the fresh elections were announced. 12th Lok Sabha. This was the third consecutive Lok Sabha, like the 10th and 11th Lok Sabha elections, that did not provide the country with a stable government. Atal Bihari Vajpayee became the 16th Prime Minister of India, but the government lasted for 13 months due to not able to get support from other parties. Now look at this picture. Here is a Lok Sabha and duration of Lok Sabha. First Lok Sabha from May 1952 to April 1957, like this. 8th Lok Sabha from Jan 1985 to November 1989. 12th Lok Sabha from March 1998 to April 1999. And now 17th Lok Sabha is continuing from May 2019 till date. Now there is another fact file. The year 2002 marked the 50th year of formation of the Lok Sabha. The Golden Jubilee of Parliament of India was celebrated on May 12 under the leadership of the then Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Parliament celebrated its Golden Jubilee means 50th year of formation of the Lok Sabha in year 2002. This celebration was done on 12th May under the leadership of Atal Bihari Vajpayee. Mm-hmm. He was Prime Minister at that time. Thank you.